Token Terminal is a platform that aggregates financial and alternative data on blockchains and decentralized applications. We manage a best-in-class, multi-chain crypto data warehouse that helps you focus on research and analysis and avoid resource-intensive data engineering. Our software indexes and extracts all raw smart contract events and function calls from blockchains to our internal database. Our researchers then use SQL to transform the data into standardized and comparable business metrics. Our suite of standardized and comparable metrics that we make available for all crypto projects include market, GMV, financial, valuation, cash management, and alternative data. If at any time during this video you have questions about a specific metric, please refer to our key metrics cheat sheet available at tokenterminal.com/docs. Now let's get to it. In this video, I'll walk you through how to best navigate the Token Terminal platform. To start off, make sure to create an account if you have not yet done so. Your account page is a convenient place to store and track your favorite projects, charts, and custom tables that you'll learn to create in this video. Starting from the homepage of the terminal, the first thing you'll find is a chart that displays the data for the top projects by metric. You can toggle by the metric you want to view from the drop-down here, and filter by market sector from the menu next to the chart. Market sectors are categories of projects that operate in the same vertical and are thus most comparable to each other. For example, we can easily view the fees generated by Layer 1 blockchains, decentralized exchanges, or NFT marketplaces. From the top left, you can choose whether you want to display the data as cumulative by project or as a timeline, and select the time range over which you want to view the data. That a daily, monthly, or yearly granularity. All charts also give you the option to view the data as a percentage share, as an aggregated sum of all projects, or as cumulative. If you want to remove a project from the chart, all you have to do is click on it in the legend. In the bottom right corner of every chart, you'll find the following: an info icon that brings up the methodology and sources for the data shown in the chart, the embed code for the chart, an expand option to get a better view of the chart, to take a screenshot, for example. You'll notice that you can also find the chart's sources and methodology from this expand view. Then there's a copy link option to share the chart directly, and finally a download button for downloading the chart's data as a CSV file. Below the first chart, you'll find our weekly movers section, which provides a snapshot of the top weekly gainers and losers based on different metrics. Under that, we have the data table that allows you to easily navigate all projects and metrics in a table format with advanced filtering options. The data table can be filtered based on blockchain ecosystem, market sector, and metric. Each column can also be filtered according to the values of your choice. If you want to customize the table you have in front of you, click the edit icon. In this edit view, select the metrics you want to see in your data table and click save. For example, let's create a custom table that showcases the 30-day fee and revenue values and trends, and add token incentive data to accompany that. Then all I have to do is click save to update the data table. Now that we have the custom table in front of us, what I'm going to do is add a filter that I only want to see the projects that have generated over $5,000 worth of fees in the past 30 days, and then sort the table by the 30-day revenue trend. As you can see, this data table is a great tool for sorting and filtering through all of the data available on Token Terminal to uncover valuable insights. Do note that the data table can also be downloaded as a CSV file from the bottom right corner. If you want to save a table that you created to your account page so that you can easily access it whenever you need, click the Save as Custom Table button. As the data table is such a powerful tool, you'll notice that it's available in many parts of the platform, and can also be accessed in a full screen view by navigating to our Crypto Screener page. Finally, note that you can download a master sheet of all the data on Token Terminal from the button at the bottom left of the navigation bar. You also have the option to create custom charts in our chart builder. To render a chart, start by selecting a metric and a project. As an example, I'll build a chart that compares the daily active users and the trading volumes on Blur and OpenSea. In addition to the customizability, all other functionality of the custom charts is the same as in other charts on the terminal. Now that you're familiar with the basic elements of the Token Terminal platform, charts and tables, we'll move on to explore the 6 different ways to interact with on-chain data on the platform. Starting from the metrics page, which you'll find in the left navigation bar, the first view is an overview of all the metrics available on Token Terminal. Each metric has a dedicated card that showcases the aggregated number of that respective metric for all projects listed on Token Terminal, and information about the leading project's dominance in terms of that metric. For example, the aggregated total amount of daily active users amongst all projects listed on Token Terminal is 4.9 million. And 27.9% of that 4.9 million are daily active users of the Layer 1 blockchain Tron. Each metric-specific dashboard has three sections: key metrics, competitive landscape, and a data table. You can navigate directly to each section via the card. Using the token incentives page as an example, the key metrics view shows the USD value of each protocol's governance tokens that have been distributed to users. Remember, you can always find the methodology for a metric by clicking the info button next to the chart or by expanding the chart. You can filter the key metrics chart by market sector, choose whether you want to display the data as cumulative by project or as a timeline, and select the time range over which you want to view the data. All charts also give you the option to view the data as a percentage share, as an aggregated sum, or as cumulative. The competitive landscape chart lets you easily compare projects to each other. From the dropdowns, select the metric and projects that you want to compare. You can remove selected projects by clicking X. All other functionality in the competitive landscape charts is the same as in the key metrics chart. Each metrics dashboard includes a data table, which we covered in the first section of this video, showcasing the data related to the metric page that you're on. Remember that you can always edit the chart to your liking. The next page you'll find in the left navigation bar is the market sectors page, where the first view is an overview of all the market sectors available on Token Terminal. Market sector pages make it easy to compare all projects within a given vertical. Each market sector has a dedicated card that showcases the aggregated number for a selected metric for the projects within that market sector that are listed on Token Terminal. You'll also find information about the leading project's market dominance and the number of projects we are currently tracking within that market sector. Similar to metrics dashboards, market sector dashboards also have three sections: key metrics, competitive landscape, and a data table. You can navigate directly to each section via the card. The overview section gives us a snapshot view of the current state of the market sector, showcasing the most relevant KPIs, their development, and the dominating project's market share by metric. You can filter the key metrics chart by metric, select the time range over which you want to view the data, and view the data as a percentage share, an aggregated sum, or as cumulative. Remember, you can always find the methodology used for the data in the chart by clicking the info button or by expanding the chart. The competitive landscape chart lets you easily compare projects to each other. From the dropdowns, select the metric and the project that you want to compare. You can remove selected projects by clicking X. All other functionality in the competitive landscape charts is the same as in the key metrics chart. Each market sector dashboard also includes a data table, which we covered in the first section of this video, showcasing the data related to the market sector page you're on. Do remember that you can always edit the chart to your liking. Then let's take a look at the project dashboards. Open the search menu and find a project you want to dig into. I'll use Compound as an example. Project dashboards offer project-specific market, usage, financial, valuation, and developer data available in both aggregate and composition format. Project pages are generally split into 8 subpages, which you can find in the left navigation bar. We'll go through them one by one. The top of the key metrics page includes a description of the project and a snapshot overview of a project's key metrics and their 30-day growth rates. If you want to save a project to your favorites list, click the star and it will be added to the favorites list on your account page. You'll also find two buttons in the first card: View Data Sources and Business Model. The View Data Sources button opens up a list of the on-chain sources used to calculate the data you see in the charts. The Business Model button opens up a visualization of the project's fund flows to help you understand how value flows through and to a protocol. In the key metrics chart, you can analyze different metrics over different timeframes and granularities. Remember, you can always find the methodology used for the data in a chart by clicking the info button or by expanding the chart. The revenue share chart showcases how fees generated are split between supply-side participants and the protocol. If you have questions about a specific metric that the methodology text doesn't answer, you can always refer to the key metrics cheat sheet available on our docs page. The link to this is in the description. The composition by contract chart lets you analyze the different contracts that make up the composition of a selected metric. We can see here that most of Compound's fees generated come from USDC, DAI, and USDT contracts. This chart can also be viewed as cumulative or as a percentage share to see how the relative usage of different contracts has developed. The composition by chain chart shows us which chains contribute the most to the chosen metric. You can find information about which chains we track for any given project by navigating the key metrics page and checking the icons under the name of the project. We currently only track Compound on Ethereum, so we'll only see data for that in the composition by chain chart. But as an example, let's look at the lending protocol Aave, which we're tracking on all chains it's deployed on, so Ethereum, Polygon, Avalanche, Arbitrum, Optimism, and Phantom. From this chart, we can, for example, analyze how net deposits are distributed between these chains, or which of these chains generate the most fees for the protocol. Going back to Compound's dashboard, The next section is the competitive landscape chart, where we can, for example, compare Compound to Aave based on any metric you select from the dropdown. On the vesting schedule page, you can view how a project's tokens are vested or unlocked over time for different stakeholders. This chart is a great place to find out what percent of a project's governance tokens will be unlocked in the near future. Then we have the financial statement page, which shows all the information about the financial performance of a DAO in a TradFi-friendly format. We'll explore the financial statements in more detail a bit later on in this video. Finally, each project page has a data table that you can customize to your liking. The Trending Contracts page allows you to explore the most active contracts and addresses across different blockchains. You can filter the table by chain, market sector, project, and timeframe. Once you've selected the scope of your analysis, you can then sort the data by account age, gas used, percent of the gas market, number of transactions, average gas per transaction, active users, asset inflows, and asset outflows. This is a great tool for finding emerging trends and momentum shifts in crypto while being able to pinpoint exactly where activity is coming from. For example, I can check which market sectors are responsible for the majority of gas usage on Arbitrum, and then dig deeper by filtering by project, and then by contract. Then we have the Financial Statements tab, which is a collection of real-time financial statements for DAOs. These financial statements show all the information about the financial performance of a DAO in a TradFi-friendly format. You can view a project's financial statement in a weekly, monthly, quarterly, or yearly format, and download that statement as a PDF or CSV file. The financial statement is a great format for spotting trends and assessing the high-level performance of a DAO at a glance. You can toggle the Show Definitions button for a description of what each metric means. The final and most advanced way to interact with data on Token Terminal is via our API. The Token Terminal API allows you to access all of the data that powers the Token Terminal web application. Users on the Token Terminal API plan can query the data with their designated API key, which can be found on their account page. The API can be, for example, used to create a portfolio monitoring app to figure out which tokens to sell or buy more of. Head over to our API docs to read more and try it out. I hope you found this video helpful. Make sure to leave a comment if you have any questions, and join the discussion on our governance forum at gov.tokenterminal.com, a place for the crypto community to discuss and evaluate DAOs. You can find the link to this and all our other socials in the description.